After studying this module, you should be able to understand the main ideas of Maslow's humanistic psychology, know about the personal history of Maslow, learn about the contributions of Maslow, analyze the basic assumptions underlying his theory. History of humanistic psychology dates back to the period of the post-World War II, where an eclectic approach was used among different psychologists like behaviorism, psychoanalysis, and cognitive approaches before humanistic psychology came into being. The formation of fundamental ideas about humanistic psychology goes back to the period of ancient Greece. The humanistic psychologists wanted to form a force in psychology which went beyond the mistakes and restricted view portrayed by others. Basically, humanistic psychologists stressed upon adding concepts to the approaches or concepts of other schools. Humanistic approach has its roots in existentialist thought. Some of the major thinkers who are associated with this paradigm are: for need hierarchy theory is Abraham Maslow. Carl Rogers was associated with the development of person-centered approach. Laura and Fritz Perl for the creation and development of Gestalt psychology. It was assumed by humanistic theorists that the individual is an active, creative being who lives in the present and subjectively responds to current perceptions, relationships, and activities. The humanistic approach of psychology is an optimistic approach which focuses on the growth and actualization of the human being. The American psychologist Abraham Maslow from the year 1908 to 1970 is well thought of as the father of humanistic psychology. He was keen on expanding the realm of psychology beyond the other two forces, which were namely psychoanalysis and behaviorism. Therefore, he referred to his humanistic psychology as the third force in psychology, and considering transpersonal psychology as the fourth force in the field of psychology. Humanistic psychology stresses to know what constitutes positive mental health and tries to examine the positive qualities of the people rather than on their drawbacks. That is to say, it desires to emphasize on well-being and health in contrast to looking at maladaptive behavior or mental, emotional, behavioral disorders. Abraham Maslow wanted to highlight and understand the constructive side of mental health of an individual in contrast to that of majority of psychologists who were immersed in reviewing the psychogonomics of human nature that were considered maladaptive. He was preoccupied in studying those aspects which focused on improving mental health, human potential, and seeking peak experiences and personal growth, which also had an enduring consequence on psychology. Humanistic psychology helped in creating numerous therapies which were based on the assumption that each individual possesses inner potential for improving and growth. Thus, the main aim of the therapy is to provide such environment that is conducive for the growth of an individual. Similar to Carl Rogers, even Maslow discarded the deterministic nature of both psychoanalysis and behaviorism, and instead that one acts as they do because of the way they perceive their circumstances. Maslow is known for coming up with quite a number of key notions for humanistic psychology, such as self-actualization. Key features of self-actualized individuals are peak experience, that is, reaching one's high or living in a plateau. He is also prominently known for developing the concept of a hierarchy of human needs, ranging from deficiency needs or D needs, that is, need for safety, nourishment, love, belongingness, self-respect, and self-esteem, the lack of which can lead to neurosis or psychosis, up to higher being needs, that is also referred to as B needs, the need to engage in meaningful, helpful work and service, to promote justice, to creatively express oneself, to find spiritual fulfillment and self-transcendence in realizing what is one's true potential, beautiful, good, the lack of which can lead to meta-psychology. Maslow himself formed his work Positive Psychology rather than Humanistic Psychology, and Positive Psychology has of late grown. Later on, Maslow added and extended his concepts of Humanistic Psychology and came up with the fourth force, which was Transpersonal Psychology, ideal of self-transcendence, full spiritual awakening or liberation from egocentricity. Consequently, it can be concluded that humanistic approach to psychology stresses upon the free will and positive side of an individual. In contrast to Freud's theory of biological determinism, this approach is evidently different. An additional important asset of this approach is that humanistic psychology theory is compatible with other school of thoughts. Maslow's need hierarchy theory can also be applied to several new areas and is used even today in fields like finance, management, economics, history, or criminology. Personal history of Abraham Maslow. Early years. Maslow was born on 1st April 1908 in Manhattan, the first child of Russian Jewish immigrants Samuel and Rose Maslow, who were first generation Jewish immigrants from Russia who fled from Tsarist persecution in the early 20th century and had seven children. His parents had decided to live in New York City and in multi-ethnic working class neighborhood. Even though Maslow's parents were not intellectual and poor, they were still aware of the significance of education and wanted their children to be educated. Thus, because of which, Maslow was the only Jewish boy in his neighborhood, as a result of which he was lonely and unhappy throughout his childhood. Apart from this, Maslow had a lot of problems in his household because of which he and his father were frequently at odds. Maslow reported that during his childhood, his father always belittled him and pressed him to outdo in areas that were of no meaning to him. Such remarks of his father made him viewing himself as disgusting, and as a result, it had a very negative influence on him, leading to a very low self-image and esteem in Maslow. Despite this, Maslow's father wanted him to do well academically, because of which he was inclined towards reading, education, and career. After high school, when Maslow was 17, he enrolled into the City College of New York. In addition to his undergraduate course, Lord Maslow in 1926, to satisfy his father, he began taking legal studies classes at night. Within 2 weeks of attending the law college, he realized that he detested it so much that he immediately dropped out of it. In 1927, he moved to Cornell. However, he became disheartened, and for some time he lost his love for psychology. But later on, he returned to New York and re-enrolled at the City College. Once again, he later on graduated from City College and went to graduate school at Wisconsin University to study psychology. It was surprising to note that it was the work of John B. Watson which had an impact on Maslow and inspired him to come back to psychology. Even though Watson's work was as much mechanistic as Titchener's structuralism, it revealed a belief of the equality of human being and the improvability of society. Likewise, the book which was written by Freud, titled as The Interpretation of Dreams, also captivated him. Although he found his work sometimes boring, in Harry Harlow's lab, he was convinced that this field was meant for him and took his work seriously. Alfred Adler's concepts about the need to feel dominant and powerful also had an impact on him. Maslow became the first doctoral student of Harry Harlow, a renowned experimental psychologist of that time. Maslow's dissertation involved nomination amongst a colony of monkeys. In the year 1934, Maslow was conferred with his PhD, after which also he continued to teach at the university. But in the year 1935, he shifted to the University of Columbia as a fellow. He continued to work with the distinguished Edward L. Thorndike for 18 months, approximately in the University of Columbia. Even though both Thorndike and Maslow worked closely, he gave Maslow an intelligence test, and the result were a surprise to them. As for Maslow, he got an IQ score of 195. Almost immediately, Maslow began his research on human sexuality at the instance of Thorndike. Maslow published several articles on the subject of female sexuality during the period from 1937 to 1942, he revealed that females who were more dominating had a tendency to be extroverted and additionally more adventurous sexually. He also made an assumption that females who were more dominating were attracted to those males who were high on dominance and who were self-confident, whereas it was observed that those females who were low on dominance were attracted to similar types of males who were gentle and friendly. He found a mentor in Alfred Adler, who was Sigmund Freud's early colleague. He continued his research on identical themes at the University of Columbia. Maslow once again relocated in 1937 to Brooklyn College and remained there till 1951 on the faculty over there. It was Maslow's early life experiences which had an influence in his psychological ideas. Maslow continuously there is research in the area of human sexuality and at the same time continued to teach. After joining the Brooklyn faculty, he eventually realized that the advancement was very sluggish in that place, that after the long period of 8 years, he became an assistant professor over there. In spite of the fact that his pupils cherished his easygoing style of teaching, and because of which he was content to inculcate his knowledge to groups of people who were happy to be receiving an opportunity to be in school after growing up in tough Jewish conflicting racial New York neighborhoods. Seeing all this, Maslow realized the prominence of counseling these young people and began counseling some of them informally. At the same time as the war began, Maslow also underwent two internal changes which had significant impact on him, and that is why stayed with him even afterwards. The first significant consequence was the birth of his two daughters. The second event occurred when he saw a rather pathetic parade of veterans near Brooklyn College. This resulted in Maslow's coming up with an article in 1943 on a theory of human motivation. He developed the theory of hierarchy of needs and the knowledge that led to psychopathology, as in Karen Horney's system of basic needs, whereas meeting them led to health and wholeness. Maslow's mentors at the New School for Social Research in New York included Alfred Adler, Eric Fromm, Karen Horney, and Med. It was seen that the impact of war stirred a vision of peace in Maslow, which also led him to come up with his groundbreaking psychological studies of self-actualizing people. These studies began with these two mentors, namely anthropologist Ruth Benedict and Max Wertheimer, one of the gestalt psychologists whom Maslow had great regard for both personally and professionally. Maslow started taking down notes for both these individuals, as they were so proficient as human beings as well as in their profession. This resulted in the development of his research and work on focusing on human growth and mental health. Maslow did a comprehensive work on this topic and even derived a lot of concepts from other psychologists, however, adding a lot of new ideas to them. For instance, to the concepts of need hierarchy, motives, higher order needs, self-actualizing persons, and attainment of peak experience. As Maslow made plans for doing further research on similar aspects, in 1947, Maslow's work got disrupted as an unexpected ailment deprived him of any energy he had, due to which he had his initial bouts of fatigue, depression, and heartbeat, and series of many such bouts followed, due to which he had a heart attack and eventually he had to take a medical leave. This illness forced Maslow to move to California along with his two daughters and wife Rose. During this period, he headed a division of the Maslow Corporation. Once he recovered from his illness in the year 1949, he came back to Brooklyn College. Maslow in the year 1951 took up the post of head of the department psychology in the University of Brandeis, a new school where he stayed till the year 1969 and even headed as the chairman of the department of psychology. Maslow became the resident fellow in the institute in California. During this period, he came in contact with Kurt Goldstein, who was one who had authored the well-known book entitled The Organism in the year 1934 and initiated the idea of self-actualization. During this time only, he started his movement of humanistic psychology, which became very important to even then his own concepts of theory. Even though he got a lot of opportunities in Brandeis University and he had a talented faculty, he was not satisfied working over there. His colleagues considered his notions to be immature and his scholars showed little of the respect or motivation he was used to at the College of Brooklyn. This was reflected in his journal, where he openly criticized about his students who had a need of specifically more for guidance from him. His model of the relationship was that his pupils ought to learn what they may, perhaps from their teachers, from above down, without being a diversion from more significant concerns such as creating and pinning down theory of psychology. Due to this disturbed relationship in his childhood with his mother, he took up psychoanalysis, but soon after he assumed the control of what is to be referred to as the third force in psychology. Maslow in the year 1954 published his book Motivation and Personality. This book challenged the psychologist to spend less time on understanding the people who were mentally ill and weak and instead prompted them to focus on those individuals who were mentally healthy and had the inner potential to grow according to their resources. It was this time that the Association of American Psychology began declining articles of Maslow for publication. Maslow's article on peak or transcendent experience of joy, bliss and unity had an adverse impact on those individuals who were used to reading about rigidity and pessimism. During the year of 1961, Maslow along with Tony founded the Journal of Humanistic Psychology with Milosevic as editor until the year of 1971. This journal came up in early 1961 with its first issue and still remains to print academic papers. In the year of 1962, Maslow founded the Humanistic Psychology Association with the help of a group of colleagues. These comprised of such prominent theorists as Carl Rogers and even Rollo May. Maslow was influenced by existentialist philosophers and contributed himself to humanistic psychology and philosophy. Maslow long believed that leadership should be non-intervening. Maslow was nominated President of the Psychology Association of America on July 8, 1966. Since his health was not good, in 1968 he decided to quit teaching. Maslow was offered a fellowship by the administrative of SAG, which Maslow accepted it cordially, and he was very much comfortable, happy and relaxed in his new position. Again, during the year 1967, Maslow had an almost fatal heart attack and knew his time was limited. Maslow gave forthcoming psychologists a momentum by bringing to light different pathways to think upon, and thus he was considered to be one of the pioneers in invitation of concepts in psychology. During the same time, Maslow was conferred by the American Humanistic Association as the Humanist of the Year award. Maslow was concerned with questions such as, why don't more people self-actualize if their basic needs are met? How can we humanistically understand the problem of evil? He spent his final years in semi-retirement in California. While Maslow was jogging, he suffered from another heart attack and died at the age of 62 years on June 8, 1970 in California, after years of suffering from poor health. General outline of Maslow's approach. During the late 1950s, humanistic approach to psychology started becoming more popular and gaining momentum, with Maslow being considered broadly as its founding father. Maslow perceived that other approaches of psychology negatively depicted individuals because it highlighted on the negative, destructive, and animalistic aspect of human behavior. In contrast to this, Maslow was positive that he could articulate a comprehensive theory of human motivation. He sought after a theory that would include both the positive and negative aspects of human dispositions. Maslow hoped that this third force, namely humanistic psychology, would be the answer to this problem. He theorized that the holistic analytic approach to science could be effective. Maslow asserted that this approach to psychology would study the human being as expressing, feeling, and thinking beings, individuals as entirely thinking and feeling. Maslow even went so far as to criticize other scientists of that time who did not use this approach, claiming that they were afraid to uncover their own nature. Basic assumptions of Maslow's theory. Humanistic psychology theory focuses on the positive aspect of the individual and believes in free will. This theory clearly contrasts with Freud's theory of biological determinism. One more important forte is that humanistic psychology theory is compatible with other schools of thought. Maslow's rationale was unique. Earlier, majority of psychologists in the past had been apprehensive with the abnormal and the ill. He advised people to recognize their basic needs before addressing higher needs and eventually self-actualization. He desired to be acquainted with what constituted positive mental health. Humanistic psychology contributed in developing various diverse therapies, all directed by the perception that people hold the inner resources for growth and healing, and that the main aim of therapy is to support in eradicating stumbling blocks of individuals so that they can realize their full potential. The prominent of these was client-centered therapy developed by Carl Rogers. The fundamental doctrine behind humanistic psychology are simple. These are: humanistic psychologists lay emphasis on the present situation as an alternative of probing the past or make an effort to the future. Someone's present functioning for them is the most important aspect. According to humanistic psychologists, one must take personal responsibility for their actions, irrespective of its consequences. That is, whether the actions are positive or negative, to be psychologically healthy. This approach views each individual to be inherently worthy, even though the given action they perform might be destructive. These actions do not dismiss out the worth of an individual. This perspective feels that the major goal of an individual is to accomplish understanding and personal growth. Only through persistent self-understanding and improvement, one can become truly content and happy. Contribution of Maslow to the field of psychology. It was that phase in psychology when majority of psychologists were focusing their attention on those characteristics of human being which were well thought out to be atypical. Whereas it was Maslow who directed his attention to focus on the constructive aspect of psychological well-being. His attention in growth of an individual looking for peak experiences and enlightening mental health by observing for subjective progressions had an enduring impact on psychology. While Maslow's work was criticized by many academic psychologists, still his theories had an impact on many aspects owing to the great than before awareness in the area of well-being and positive aspect of psychology. Maslow's term self-actualization was one of the key features of humanistic psychology. The term self-actualization means that each person is born with the need to attain their full potential. Maslow decided to emphasize his study on those individuals who were psychologically healthy, and he recognized it as peak experience. Instances where the individual is in thorough harmony and unison with the world around them. Instead of focusing on the deficiencies, humanistic theories laid emphasis on the positive aspect of individuals and finding people's strength. Unlike what other psychologists and theorists felt, Maslow believed that his philosophy was a complement to Freudian psychology. He said that while Sigmund Freud concentrated on treating sick people, his approach focused on facilitating people determine positive outcomes and choices. Maslow's hierarchy can be applied to various other areas, like, for instance, organization, economics, and even in political history and criminology. Some of the significant work for which Abraham Maslow is prominently known: Need Hierarchy of Humans, Maslow's concept of basic and higher order needs, his conception of tendency of self-actualizing individual, notion of the peak experience. It can be summed up that during the 1950s, Maslow became one of the initiators and main person who was responsible for growth and widespread awareness of what came to be recognized as humanistic psychology. His concepts, comprising of transpersonal psychology, Jhana complex, need hierarchy, actualization and peak experience, turn out to be the central themes humanistic movement. The basic assumption of Maslow was that humans develop in positive and constructive manner if they are provided with conducive environment. Summary: Maslow is regarded as the father of the third force known as the humanistic psychology, the other two being psychoanalysis and behaviorism. Maslow was concerned about the potential of an individual, how one could attain peak experiences, how mental health could be improved significantly, and how one could achieve personal growth. Maslow substantiated and extended his concepts of humanistic psychology and came up with the fourth force, which was known as the transpersonal psychology. Maslow's term self-actualization was one of the key features of humanistic psychology. It refers to the belief that people are born with the need to attain their maximum potential. Maslow was nominated president of the American Psychological Association on July 8, 1966, and in 1967 was facilitated with American Humanistic Association Humanist of the Year. Maslow's work was criticized by many academic psychologists. Still, his theories had an impact on many aspects due to the rising interest in positive psychology. The main features of Maslow's theory of personality, which would be discussed in the next module, are hierarchy of needs, deficiency needs, and being needs, self-actualization tendency, and peak experience.